Hello, my name is Loretta Harrison. I'm with Loretta's Authentic Pralines. And today we're making a batch of the original pralines. We're about to add our sugar to the amazing copper kettle, which is one of the best pots there is to make candy. The copper kettle is good for candy making because it holds heat. The first step is to add the sugar. And because we make large amounts, we use a lot of sugar. Because a praline is basically a sugar candy. And the recipe that we use here is a recipe that's handed down from my mother, from her mother, from her mother. As far as we know, it's handed down from 5 generations. And now we add milk. Some people use, when they make pralines, they use water. They use cotton milk. I use evaporated milk. So now in here we have sugar and milk. Then with that, I add lots of butter. I love butter. And I love to use the salted butter because it cuts the real sweetness. So we let this cook, sugar and butter, and the milk. We let it cook. I would say it cooks for 30 minutes. This cooks. Then once it cooks up, cook back down, we go to another step. And these are my agitators. I love these, because they do most of the work for me. So what has happened here? Step one, with the sugar, the milk, and the butter, has cooked up and then cooked back down. Once it cooked back down, then I add the pecans. And I like to add lots, because I don't want the customers to say, oh, I bit into your pralines and there were no pecans. So we add that. Then we let that cook some more. While that's cooking with the pecan, I add a little flavoring. And they say, oh, you never measure anything. I've been making pralines for 33 years, so I know it's right. Now we let that cook for a few minutes. And then once that cooked together, and I look at it, I don't have a thermometer of any sort, I just look at it. And I know when it's ready. I know this one is ready. Okay, so I'm gonna pull out the agitator. I'm gonna let some of the candy drip off of the agitator. And then what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna send the agitator back to this pot and let it whip from there. And this is where I come in with it. She's ready. What I'm doing now, I have to hand spoon the pralines out of the pot while the agitator whips it for me. This is where I come in. I spoon it out. Now people ask me, they say, oh, don't you get tired of making pralines and working with pralines? No. God has blessed me with the ability to really make something that I really enjoy. And for me, it's not a chore, but it's a passion. I love making candy. And a lot of people tell me that it shows. Because with all the praline makers in the city of New Orleans, everybody can make pralines and their mama. But when you have the community, the people here that rally behind your business, then you have a wonderful product. Ready. That's how it's made here at Loretta's Authentic Pralines.